Hi there, welcome back. My name is Galit Raymond, and today I'm going to talk to you about the full moon in Aquarius. This full moon is taking place on August 1st, 2023 at 11:32 a.m. Pacific Daytime. A full moon is always when the sun and the moon are in opposite direction from each other, and so there is a pull. There is more light, we can see better. And this full moon is in Aquarius, that means that the sun is in Leo, just opposite of Aquarius, and the moon is in Aquarius. So we really need to deal with this axis of individual expression, which is the Leo part, versus social expression, which is the Aquarius part. And you know, society is built from many, many individuals, and they all come together to create a voice. That is the voice of the collective. And that voice have many, many components. Those are all individuals, and each individual has their own world, their own beliefs. But together, somehow, there is a voice to the collective, and that voice is being shown to us by what the society is doing, how we vote for our presidency, what kind of countries are we building. This is a big voice. It matters for each and every one of us because we all live within that society of ours. Wherever it may be for you in the world, you still live in a society that has a certain idealism, certain belief system, and certain institutions that are working according to that belief system of the society. So you matter. You're a part of that voice. We all are a part of that voice. And that is the tricky part of Aquarius. On the one hand, Aquarius is the collective. It's all of us together. It's the society. But it is also the unique personality's contribution into that society. So each and every one of us matters because the shift or the ideas or the notions that we bring into our society, our collective, our tribe, be it your friend circle, be it your family, you ripple this out. And other people hear your ideas and your values, and they may be affected by it. And this affects change in people. Therefore, Aquarius represents change. Aquarius represents fresh ideas. Aquarius represents individualistic ideas coming into the collective and making a difference in the collective. That's why we all say change starts with us, and it does because of those traits. If we come up with an idea, with something that is an invention, inventive ideas, new ideas, every invention that you see around you started with one person. They had an idea, they went for it, they gather a mass of people to support their idea. If you want to take the startup life as an example, that's a good example. One person comes with an idea that is the dreamer, the vision, and then they gather people around them, and slowly, slowly they form this company that eventually becomes Amazon or Facebook or any one of those giant companies that we see around us. They started with one person's idea. And so it really matters what you think, what you do, what you come up with, because this can affect a huge change in the world. And I'm going to share my screen and show you this full moon so we can derive more meaning out of it. Here is my screen. Here is the sun at 9 degrees Leo, and here is the moon at 9 degrees Aquarius. They're just across from each other, but they're also forming a T-square to Jupiter in Taurus. Now, Jupiter in Taurus is interested in the finance world, in creating more stability and abundance in the sign of Taurus, which is the sign of resources, which is the sign also of our values, but definitely what resources do we have in the physical world and how we can use them. A square is always a tension that needs to be accompanied by an action. And the action point, the apex, is Jupiter. So Jupiter says, you want expansion, you want financial security, you have to shift something within the laws that are governing your society and your belief system, how you come as individuals, that is the expression of Leo, and how you come together as a society. What do you do with your resources as individuals and as society? And every sign has a positive and a negative expression. So the Leo positive expression is doing the right thing, being proud, serving as an example, being good leaders. But the negative things are vain, are using others in a powerful way. So are we seeing some examples of the negative? I bet we do. Also, Aquarius has a positive and a negative. On a beautiful day, Aquarius is equality, democracy, being all together, upgrading our society for the better good of all. On a negative way, it's being disconnected emotionally and oppressing people because of the idealism that Aquarius may hold, that they are right in their point of view. Do we see that on the planet right now? Do we see extremes? Aquarius deals with extremes? Yes, we do. And do we see extremes that are exploiting resources? Yes, we do. So it's that time on the planet when the nodes have just shifted into Libra South Node and Aries North Node. The South Node is always a release point of the underbelly of that sign. And so in Libra, there is a lot of underbelly to be released, especially regarding resources and abundance and the monetary system and how we use those resources for better or worse. And I wrote some points for the underbelly of Libra, South Node. What are we releasing? We don't have time to be codependent, to be complaining, to be self-indulgent, to be indecisive, to be manipulative, to be materialistic, to be self-serving, to be easily influenced, to be out of balance. And we are. We are out of balance in many areas in our life, and we see it all around us, and especially in relationships. And that's what the Libra South Node premise is, to heal those points where we are only seeing ourselves instead of seeing the equality, harmony, grace, helping others, all the beautiful traits that Libra has. We're seeing the underbelly. And relationships are the key. Let's go back to the chart and see what it is. So here is a sign for relationship. We have Venus retrograding in Leo, helping us reevaluate what our values are and how we want to show up in our relationship, how we want to accept love and how we want to give love. And she's retrograding because we need to upgrade and reevaluate some stuff within ourselves, how we relate. But she's also in a square position to Uranus. And Uranus is the ruler of this full moon, right? Uranus is in Taurus square in Venus, saying we have to have some reevaluation. We have to break some patterns. Uranus always helped us to make a change and break something. We have to break some patterns in relatedness. And Venus can be vain. She is the ruler of the South Node in Libra. We have to break some relatedness patterns that leads us to vanity and self-indulgence. And we have to change and shift those patterns to become the North Node in Aries. North Node in Aries is all about being independent, being a leader, taking risk and being courageous, speaking our truth. So this full moon is all about that the time has come to speak our truth. We can no longer live with injustice, societal injustice and personal injustice. We just came out from the Taurus Scorpio nodal axis that has been with us for 18 months, and we have all been through a lot of trauma. And Pluto just travels back into Capricorn, 29, 28 degrees Capricorn in this chart, saying, take a good look for almost the last time before it moves back to Aquarius. Take a good look at your systems. Take a good look at how you build your institutions, how you build your box of security system. What's working, what's not? What's corrupted, what's not? What needs to change, what's not? And pay attention to where abuse and power and manipulation are happening versus a new fresh air that some people are bringing to the surface, saying, hey, we need to change something on a societal level, collective level, and personal level. And it is always starting with a personal level. So where is this axis in your chart, the Leo Aquarius axis? Where is it? What new inventions, fresh ideas, your idealism comes to the surface? Where is it that you want to do something for the greater good of all? Where do you want to participate? Where do you want to be in your tribe? Who is your tribe? Where do you want to fit in into society and bring your gift, the Leo individual, beautiful individual that you are, where is that gift of yours, that talent? Where are you going to bring it? Are you going to participate and make a ripple effect, make your mark in this life? Or are you going to sit aside and complain, Libra South Node, complain about the injustice, the unfairness, or whatever it is? I think this full moon gives us all an opportunity to show up and become something greater than ourselves. And that's the power of the collective. How can one person become so powerful that it affects the collective? And all we have to do is show up, speak our truth, be in our center, and do something, create action, because only through action we really create change. The other thing that's going on in this chart is Mercury at 5 degrees Virgo, just in opposition to Saturn at 5 degrees Pisces. Saturn in Pisces helps us become more idealistic, helps us tap into compassion, into a reality that's beyond reality, right? Tap into all this beautiful universe and creativity. Bring the dream into reality. Saturn represents the reality. Pisces represents the dream. Every creation that we can think of is possible. But we need to create it into material, into the physical world. That is Saturn in a systematic way. In opposition to Mercury in Virgo. Mercury in Virgo is discerning. Mercury in Virgo wants everything to be very efficient. It wants to have order. It wants to sift through what's needed and what's not. It's a very analytical position for Mercury to be and very practical. So let's be practical about bringing a good vision to this earth, to our life, to our collective. What a wonderful opportunity. What's also going on is Mars is in Virgo, and Mars in Virgo in opposition to Saturn, together with that Mercury saying, controlled action. What action do you want to take in a controlled, calculated, efficient, practical way in order to affect healing? Virgo is all about healing. So what are we healing? We're healing our relatedness to ourself. We are redefining who self is, who we are. So we're healing that part. We're healing relationship, how we relate to others. What are our motives to relate to others? Do we come from a place of love and acceptance or not? There are many ways we can show up in relationship. How do you show up? And how do you want to see others showing up? And we're healing the collective that went into extremes right now, and we see it all around us. So we're healing that as well. So we have to be responsible for our actions. So how can you take more responsibility for your actions and for what you spread out there in the world? What is your message? How do you bring more love into the world? And last but not least, we have a trine, a beautiful trine from Jupiter at 13 degrees Taurus to that Mars at 13 degrees Virgo. This is an earth trine. Be practical. Jupiter is giving you all the protection and the expansion and the good luck. It's a good juju, right? It's Jupiter. All the good luck and the ability to be optimistic about the work that we are currently doing. And keep that vision of optimism and idealism in your mind. Whatever you believe is whatever you create, right? Jupiter is about our belief system. So check your belief system, check your value system. Do you need to adjust something in order to bring that optimistic overview into a new vision, to a new world? We're still in the middle of this process. Some of it is very uncomfortable. We're all feeling the pressure. It's been a long time that we're feeling pulled to many, many sides, and there is a lot of tension in our bodies. Take care of your body. Maintain that body on a physical level. Eat well, sleep well, do the right thing for yourself. Stop any destructive behavior. That's the Libra South Node. If you're addicted to something, maybe it's time to take care of that and show up. Show up for yourself, first of all. And once you do that and you're strong enough, you can show up for others. So I think it's a very uplifting full moon with a message of change, but you need to be practical and take practical steps for making this change happen. It's not enough to hold the concept. We have to be proactive and do something about it. And it's about us to take personal responsibility. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Happy full moon. And thank you for watching. And please take care of yourself. And I will see you next time.